Hi there. Welcome to Team A News. I'm Brooke Fitzwater.
And I'm Jordan Lococo. It's Monday, December 12, 2016.
Let's check out the local news. Many college students may dream of solving worldwide problems, but Madeira High School graduate Maggie Griffin is doing more than just dreaming. The Ohio State University senior won $100,000 to implement her plan of growing fresh produce to feed 60 families in five Columbus public schools, where students have little access to fresh fruits and vegetables. Griffin will receive half of the money as a stipend and the other half to fund her project.
Kyle Plummer was on his way to New Richmond when he stopped at a railroad crossing as a large freight train came down the tracks. Unfortunately, Kyle got too close. Doctors were able to save his life, but they couldn't save his leg. They also had to take his hip and pelvis. 25 surgeries later, with many more lying ahead, Kyle is home.
Are you a Reds fan? If you are, then listen up. The Cincinnati Reds welcome fans to Reds Fest 2016 on December 2nd. It's one of the largest fan festivals in all of Major League Baseball. Here's a quick interview about the event.
I'll tell you what, it's crazy down here. And if you're a Reds fan, there's no place you want to be besides the Duke Energy Convention Center today and tomorrow. 23,000 plus showed up for Reds Fest last year. This year, with more space available, the crowds are expected to be even bigger.
Let's check out some world news. Have you ever tried to solve a Rubik's Cube? Well, if you want to solve the world record, your chances just got slimmer. This November 9th, the world record of solving a Rubik's Cube was broken by Matt Valks in the Netherlands. It was previously 4.9 seconds and is now 4.7. Nice job, Matt.
Picture the greatest international scavenger hunt. Now picture the greatest international scavenger hunt the world has ever seen. This August, there were 30,000 people participating in the greatest international scavenger hunt the world has ever seen, or GISHWHGS. The money raised helps many and in the process spreads kindness. Be sure to consider participating next year.
Do you know anyone suffering from Alzheimer's? There is no cure for Alzheimer's, but people participating in drug trials are helping scientists try to prevent the disease. More than 5 million Americans have Alzheimer's disease. Experts are hoping that these trials will lead to a better way to prevent Alzheimer's. Now let's throw it over to Lena with the sports report.
On Saturday, November 26th, the second-ranked Ohio State Buckeyes beat the third-ranked Michigan State Wolverines 30-27. The game went into double overtime with OSU coming out on top. The game was widely viewed as it was an important rivalry matchup between the two schools. The matchup took place in Columbus at Ohio Stadium. LeBron James has been chosen as Sports Illustrated Sports Person of the Year. James was chosen as the 2016 Sports Person of the Year after bringing home the NBA title for the Cleveland Cavaliers and ending the team's 52-year championship drought. James was honored to receive the award and joins Tiger Woods as the only two-time recipients of the title. Sports Illustrated's editor-in-chief Chris Stone says that, in the end, LeBron James was the clear choice. The Cincinnati Bengals just beat the Philadelphia Eagles. On Sunday, December 4th, the Bengals won 32-14 against the Eagles. Cincinnati scored the first six times they had the ball, with Andy Dalton throwing for two touchdowns. Bengals fans were thrilled as it had been 42 days since the last Bengals win. The Bengals will play the Browns next at Cleveland. This has been Lena Bruscato with the Sports Update.
O-H-I-O. Should be a chilly weekend in Ohio. Let's turn to Christina with the forecast.
Team A's weather reported by me, Christina Shannon. So today, Wednesday, December 7th, we have a high of 42 with a low of 29. Chances of rain are low at 10%, but winds are 5 miles an hour heading northeast. As we can see at this radar, there's not much happening up near Cincinnati and of the northern part, but as we zoom out a little bit, up at the northern part of Indiana and into Illinois, we see that snow is starting to head east towards Cincinnati, so we will in the next couple days get a little bit of snow. As we zoom out a little bit further, we see that the snow will start to get heavier as we go throughout the week, only causing it to start snowing here. So bundle up. For tonight, we have weather of 33 degrees. Temperatures will drop as we get further into the night. There's going to be some late sun in the afternoon and into the early evening. And for the 7-day forecast, we have Wednesday today at 43 with clouds and sun and a low of 31. Snow and flurries start to go through the end of the week. And over the weekend on Saturday, we have sun and clouds. On Saturday, you have a high of 34 and a really low of 18. And on Sunday, there is a high of 35 with a low of 27, warming up a little bit, but not much. On Monday and Tuesday, you follow through with the same rain or snow or some snow showers. I'm Christina Shannon, and that has been your forecast.
Thanks, Christina.
Now, let's throw it over to Emmy to get an entertainment update.
Hi there, I'm Emmy Snyder from the Indian Hill Television Network's News Center. In movies, Chris Pratt and Jennifer Lawrence star in an all-new Sony film, Passenger. Their characters Jim and Aurora were just two insignificant passengers on their ship through space to a new home. But unlike the others, who sleep in suspended animation, Jim and Aurora are awakened 90 years early, the result of a ship malfunction. Supposedly, Jim and Aurora will live the rest of their lives alone on the ship without a care in the world. But their paradise comes to an end when the two discover that the ship is in grave danger and they hold the lives of 5,000 sleeping passengers in their hands. Also this December, Universal plans to release a fun, family-friendly animated movie, Sing, starring Reese Witherspoon, Seth MacFarlane, Scarlett Johansson, Tori Kelly, Matthew McConaughey, and more. The film follows each character on the journey through the world's greatest singing competition. In music, Hailee Steinfeld is set to host the 2016 Women in Music Awards, the 10th annual of the Billboard event, created to honor the female stars and executives in music. The event will take place December 9th in New York and air on December 12th. This has been Emmy Snyder with Entertainment. Now back to the News Center with Jordan and Brooke.
Thanks, Emmy. Now we interrupt this broadcast for a public service announcement.
It may be empty.
I'm sure you've all heard that the Cubs are the new World Series champions. Lena has the scoop on this story.
Cubs fans across the country are rejoicing as Chicago beats the Cleveland Indians in the 2016 World Series. The series lasted a total of 7 games, each one more exciting than the last. The Indians almost took the title with a 3-1 lead after Game 4. But in Game 5, the Cubs pulled through and began a winning streak that lasted them through Game 7. As Chicago native Carrie Bruscato states,
"The game was super exciting. I could not believe that the Cubs finally won a World Series."
A victory for the Cubs meant not only a comeback within the series, but also a major comeback in baseball. It had been 108 years since the last time the Cubs had won the World Series. The Cubs have had to batter major obstacles, both real and legend, such as the fabled curse of the Billy Goat. Lifetime Cubs fan Jay Bruscato summarizes it perfectly.
I've been waiting a lifetime to have the Cubs, to see the Cubs win the World Series, and it finally happened.
Following the win, Chicagoans and fans alike got to fly the W as 5 million gathered together for the victory parade, and they celebrated like it was 1908.
Go Cubs! Now, Jordan has some exciting news about the marching band.
Hi, I'm Jordan LaCoco reporting on the Braves marching band. This year, the Braves have had a rather successful season, placing first in every competition.
So the band's show this year was X's and Overtures, and it featured a lot of really challenging music, and it was just constant movement, go, 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 the whole time. Very difficult stuff, but the band really rose to this challenge, and I couldn't be more proud of them. All their hard work has led them to place first in every competition we've been to this year.
It's been fun. I've gotten a lot of leadership experience, have good choreographies, a lot harder than it was in the past years.
This weekend, the Braves marching band is headed to Bands of America, a national competition. Be sure to wish them all luck.
So, go band.
Now, let's turn to Emmy for an update on the Dancer for a Day event.
Dancer for a Day is an outreach program for the Cincinnati Ballet in partnership with Cure Starts Now and Children's Hospital. Kids with pediatric brain cancer come with their siblings and families and friends and participate in an afternoon of wonderful events. They learn a little bit about being a dancer, and they learn about makeup and costuming and see a little performance. They also take a ballet class and participate that way, having a chance to feel connected to that art form and each other in a really special way.
Lastly, we have Christina telling us about horseback riding.
Hi, I'm Christina Shannon, reporting from Indian Hills Television News Network Center. Have you ever wondered what it's like to be an eventer? Well, watching this video will help you understand what we go through for 7 hours a day, almost every day of the year. We all start out at an early age because through this sport, you have to learn so much, and the more often you ride, the better you.
I love riding and the ability to have a connection with an animal, and also all the friends that I've made through riding. And it has made a difference in my life because it has allowed me to really dive into my passion for animals and extend my knowledge.
Throughout our riding careers, we go through several amounts of shows, competing against other riders from different barns. It can be very stressful, but it is a very fun process, and the more you go, the better you get at showing. The whole point of showing is to show riders what you have the capability of doing. Training horses who are young, like this one in the video, he's only 6. He's working very hard, but as you can tell, he has a lot of work to do. Training is a lot of fun, but it takes a lot of courage, and it does take a lot of time.
Showing for horseback riding is when you show off all of the hard work you've done with your horse the previous weeks, months, or years, depending on how long you've had your horse. A typical show lasts about 12 to 14 hours. You get there bright and early in the morning. You've got to clean your horse's stall and clean them up and then take them out and walk them around. After that, you have to walk your courses because there's a jumping course and a cross-country course. And the cross-country course is a bunch of jumps in an open field that are spread out a mile to 2 miles, depending on your level. And your jump course is in an arena, and you have to know where you're going around it. For jumping, you have to go over the jumps. You can't go around or stop in front of them. And you can't knock down a pole, or else you'll get points added to your score. In eventing, you want the lowest score to get the best possible ribbons. We have first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, all the way through 10. Sometimes it's only up to 8th. But it's a very fun experience, especially with the horse you have, because you've trained your horse to do all the stuff they know today. But sometimes, depending on what type of horse you have, he can be really, really good at home. He can do everything perfectly at home, but when you take him off-site to a show, he can get nervous and a little bit crazy. But that's the fun part, because you can train them how to relax at shows and just have a very fun time.
As you can see, horseback riding is not just a sport that you're able to pick up in a couple of days. It is a very intricate and time-consuming sport that requires a lot of effort in order to move up through the levels. Although I will say, once you start moving up, it becomes a lot more fun. Along with it being a lot of fun, it is a sport that you're able to stay with for a very long time, and one that you always have a passion for. I'm Christina Shannon, reporting from IHTN News. Have a great day, everyone.
Reporting live from IHTN News Studio for Team A, this has been Jordan Lococo.
And I'm Brooke Fitzwater. Have a great day and a nice winter break.